Okay, guys, in Saviour, I want you to have a look at two things. The one being, again, cash received from customers. And the second thing, which is a good calculation, it's something different, slightly different from what you've seen before, but make sure that you have a look at it. And that is our profit before tax calculation. So I'm not going to do the whole question. You can do the whole question if you want to for exercise. I think if you've done the profit before tax and the cash received from customers, you actually captured the essence of the question. Now, they gave us the statement of financial position for the 2 years 28 and 29, ordinary share capital, we have revaluation of land and building, share issue cost, retained earnings, 15% mortgage bond, land and buildings that revalued value, equipment, accumulated depreciation, listed investments at fair value. Inventories, debtors, lease allowance for credit losses, bank overdraft creditors, and income tax payable. And what they want from you is they want a statement of cash flow according to the direct method, and they want the note of the reconciliation note of profit before tax and cash generated from operations. Now, let's quickly quiz through the additional information. Number one is all about new shares and share issue costs. Number two is about the revaluation of land. And number three, the retained earnings were determined after the following items, amongst others, were taken into account. Now we have sales, depreciation, income tax. Now remember, they give us the closing balance here of retained earnings. Where's retained earnings? Here it is. Only the closing balance. So that means that our profit for the year has already been included in retained earnings. So that is why they tell you that things like depreciation and sales, that is included in that figure because it was included in the profit figure for the year. Income tax expense for the year, 17,000. Ordinary dividends declared. Now we know that that is a separately disclosable item in the statement of changes in equity, and that does not go to the income statement. Dividends received, profit on the sale of equipment, and then interest on the bank loan. Number four is all about the interest and the mortgage loan that was repaid. Number five is equipment with a cost of 15,000 was sold for 13,000 and new equipment was purchased. And then number six, during the year, illicit investment with a cost of 2,200 rand was sold for a profit of 1,300 rand. The profit on the disposal of the financial assets have not yet been taken into the account in the statement of comprehensive income. So that means that this is an adjustment entry that you have to pass. So therefore, that this amount, this profit of 1,300 rand was not included in our retained earnings as they gave it to us the above. Then they tell us the allowance for credit losses amounted to 2,000 in the first year, in 2,008 and 500 rand at the end of the year. So when we are going to do our cash received from customers, we have to take it into account because here they give us debtors less allowance for credit losses. So obviously the net debtors figure, so you have to add it back to your debtors figure in order to derive at the movement in debtors. An amount of 4,250 rand and 1,700 rand in respect of dividends is recommended included in creditors, so that's our shareholders for dividends, and cash paid to suppliers and employees, they give that figure to you. So, okay, let's quickly have a look then at our cash received from customers. They gave us the sales figure, and they also enable us to add back the 2,000 rand this year and the 500 rand last year in our debtors amount. So if you're going to go to that one, so cash received from customers, sales was 140,000. Our movement in trade debtors is the 27,000, which they gave us in our statement of financial position. That is the current year's balance. And our allowance for credit losses for the current year was 500 rand. So 27 plus 500. And then last year, our figure was 47,000, and our allowance for credit losses for 2008 was 2,000 rand. So therefore, 47 plus 2,000 last year's balance, 27 plus 500 this year's balance. So the movement then, which took place, is 21,500. It's a decrease in trade receivables, so inflow of cash. So cash received from customers, 161,500, 161,500. And they gave you the cash paid to suppliers and employees, 88,700. So cash generated from operations, 72,800. Great. Now, let's have a look at our reconciliation note. And our reconciliation note is going to start with profit before tax. Now, in order to derive at our profit before tax, our first starting point is the movement in retained earnings. So our retained earnings started last year with 48,000. It ended this year with 53,000. Now, what increases retained earnings? Profit after tax. Remember, they gave us somewhere our tax expense for the year in this very same note. Income tax expense for the year, 17,000. Great. So it is our retained earnings of last year plus profit after tax, which we don't know what it is. We have the tax though. Minus dividends declared. So dividends, not dividends received, but dividends declared. And there's that figure. Ordinary dividends declared for the year was 22,000 rand. They also gave us that figure. Now, remember that we have actually said here, we must remember to make an adjustment for that profit of 1,300 rand because that was not included in the above profit calculation. So let's go and have a look where we're going to start. We're going to start with our retained earnings in the beginning of the year of 48,000. Then we're going to say plus profit after tax, which is X at this point of time. Less dividends declared equals 22,000 rand, and that will equal our retained earnings at the end of the year of 53,000 rand. Now, if we drop down that profit for the year, which is profit after tax, that was that 27,000 rand. Our income tax expense for the year was this amount of 17,000. So if we are now going to add the 17,000 rand back, we are going to derive at my profit before tax. Now that was 44,000 rand. Now we can account for this profit on the sale of the investment of 1,300 rand, which has not yet been taken into account. So we add that back. This is the income. So it will increase our profit before tax. So our profit before tax is 45,300. So in your reconciliation note, you're going to start with profit before tax, and then it's the normal stuff. You're going to adjust it for non-cash flow items and separately disclosable items. You're going to account for changes in working capital. There's your reconciliation of cash out of operations. Then you're going to show separately disclosable items, and that's the end of the story. So what is very nice is this little profit before tax calculation. Go and have a look at that. And make sure that you understand the rationale behind that.